Austin, Texas, home to a young couple married for 4 years. Harry teaches English. Emily teaches ballet. They're expecting their first baby.
We had no prior indications that we'd be experiencing any sort of a complicated pregnancy whatsoever.
To learn that their baby had spina bifida was a shock. The birth defect can cause bowel and bladder problems and weakness and paralysis in the lower limbs.
When we got those ultrasound results, it's like everything took a 180. So we started planning a little bit differently. We read, we kind of educated, and we decided that fetal surgery was going to be our best bet.
Emily has traveled to Sacramento to be the first patient in what's known as the CURE trial, a trial for the first ever in utero stem cell treatment for spina bifida.
As soon as we knew about it, we knew that it was probably the route we wanted to take.
She's just turned out to be the perfect patient. I have so much respect all along for the women who have been willing to be the first. I mean, what an incredible gift they give to science.
Now Emily and her developing baby have a surgery date at UC Davis at 26 weeks gestation. The baby also has a name, Robbie. Robbie will receive stem cells grown at UC Davis. Another reason this campus is an ideal place for the CURE trial, it's home to a good manufacturing practice facility, also called GMP. GMP certification is given only to labs that meet the highest standards for safety and purity. At this stage of the trial, UC Davis had the only university GMP in Northern California that could manufacture these cells.
They have to be grown in a GMP facility if they're going to be put inside a person.
Scientist Priya Kumar leads the team that will be creating the stem cell patch. The patch will be applied to baby Robbie in a first-of-its-kind surgery.
Excited, elated. Sometimes I just got to pinch myself that I am in this team and I'm leading this work.
It's a process. The team suits up to practice over and over.
This is a time-dependent process. Each day, the time is very critical. The time we pull out the cells, the time we seed on the scaffold, and the time we deliver the product. Everything should be like fresh and clean and no contamination, and it's a bit stressful.
There are failures during the dry runs, allowing the team to pinpoint and solve problems.
We did at least 4 test runs, and that's when we decided, okay, it's a 4-day process.
The team also has to figure out how to safely transport the product from the lab to the hospital. In the end, they draft a procedure manual. It's 70 pages. They also decide to make backup patches in case something goes wrong. They're leaving nothing to chance, especially Kumar.
I decided, okay, let me sleep here.
Who keeps a sleeping bag in her office, ready to sleep there the night before the surgery. When it's time, the stem cell patches will be driven in a specially designated stem cell mobile across campus from the lab to the hospital. One patch will be placed on the spinal cord of the fetus in the hopes of curing the damage from her spina bifida and changing her life forever. Surgery day for mom and baby is on its way.